For Inside Carolina, I'm Taylor Vipolis, and this is the Insider Rundown, where I'll cover what I'm hearing when it comes to this UNC football team. North Carolina makes the trip from Chapel Hill to Atlanta on Friday, and the Tar Heels are sure hoping for some better luck in the ATL. Dating back to the 90s, in the series against Georgia Tech, Carolina is 4-11 on the road. The question is, how much can you really take away from that record when you bring in a whole different team? And not to make anybody feel old, you have a majority of players that weren't even born until 2000. What is more indicative is the fact that since Mac Brown returned, UNC is 1-5 in true road game settings that have kicked off at 6 p.m. or later. And it's looked severely off in some of those games, like at Florida State and Virginia last year, or more recently, its season opener at Virginia Tech. I've been told that the staff is using this game as a litmus test for true progress and confirmation that the team is taking steps in the right direction. Mac Brown has said that to be a great team, you have to win on the road. You're taking on a Georgia Tech team that has improved under Jeff Collins, but Carolina rightfully comes into this game as a double-digit favorite, so the team has to handle its business. According to Brown, he's looking for three things specifically for this team to be more like his best teams that have won consistently on the road. One, it's playing with confidence, knowing that calls might not go your way and you'll have more people than not rooting against you. Two, it's coming in with the competitive spirit and fire where the thought of getting back on the plane after a loss is enough to make you sick. And then third, it takes playing through pain, knowing that after a physical game like you just had against UVA, you might not be at 100%, yet the team needs you out there fighting for every yard. Offensively, after its best performance of the season, North Carolina has to prove it can handle the pats on the back that come with success. Last week, we went in wondering if we'd again see a heavy dose of Sam Howell in the run game, and we got a definitive answer. After picking up 112 yards on 15 attempts, it feels safe to say that Howell in the run game is the catalyst for this offense. The biggest reason being that it gives defensive coordinators something else to prepare for. As a result, defenses have to stay a bit more honest, meaning that it becomes easier for the offensive linemen to reach their assignments, or it creates more space for someone like Josh Downs to operate if more defenders get pulled into having to contain Howell. From a scout team perspective, the notion there is that the mobile quarterback is the toughest thing to prepare for, especially when you have someone like Howell that can pick you apart with just about every throw. Moving on, while everyone was too busy arguing who would get more sacks between Tamon Fox and Dez Evans this offseason, Kamen Rucker has quietly taken pole position with a team-high 3 sacks through 3 games. And that's more than fine with him, being that the sophomore is used to being overlooked by now. When you talk to people in and around the program, the belief is that Rucker would have had an offer from every team in America if he was a couple of inches taller. Instead, he went to all the camps, dominated the best of the best, and remained a 3-star off measurables. That's recruiting for you. I can tell you, though, that North Carolina is more than happy that he slipped through the cracks, only picking up one other Power 5 offer out of high school. The staff loves his energy, and it honestly looks like Rucker, who is nicknamed the Butcher, is still playing with that chip on his shoulder as he carves up offensive lines with a variety of pass rush moves. Saturday is a homecoming of sorts for Rucker, as he's from Hartwell, Georgia, which is about 2 hours outside of Atlanta. Despite being in Georgia Tech's backyard, the Yellow Jackets told him thanks, but no thanks, in regards to his scholarship. How's that for motivation? That's the rundown for this week. Stay tuned to Inside Carolina for more football coverage in the lead up to Saturday's game at Mercedes-Benz Stadium.